Hey everyone, what's up and welcome back to my channel. Today, Jacob and I are going to be talking about behavioral stuff. I had a really sweet comment from one of you guys that said like, you should totally do a video on how you parent him because he's such a good kid, which is so, so sweet. So we are going to jump right into that. So one thing I do want to say right off the top is that I do not have it all figured out at all. I am one of those moms that, just like a lot of other moms, feels really defeated a lot of the time and feels like I'm not doing what I need to be doing to be raising my kids properly. We'll go play Play-Doh in a second, okay? Do you want to do this video with me?
Yeah.
Okay. So, I'm going to just right off the top, like I said, I'm not perfect, definitely not, and I'm not in any... You can play with that. I'm not in any way a parenting guru at all, and I do not have it figured out. There are a few things that I think that really, really help. One of the things is it's just kind of Jacob's personality to be that way. He is very calm and relaxed by nature. He always has been right from birth. He's just been very easygoing. And so I think that that really, really helps with the whole personality trait stuff. He's also my first child and I'm a stay-at-home mom. So I think that that helps. He gets all of my attention always. I'm the only one that ever really is disciplining him. Basically me and his father. And so he knows what he can and cannot get away with me. I don't know. I don't really have answers. It feels kind of weird to sit down and make a video about like discipline and how I discipline him because it makes me feel like a little bit weird because I feel like I don't have it figured out. I feel like there's a lot of times when I'm not a great mom. And there's a lot of times where he has his freak out tantrums that like you guys are just not gonna see. Like I'm not a vlogger, so you guys don't see my daily life. And if he's having a freak out, I'm not adding it into the video, if that makes sense. So we do have those moments. He is a toddler. We are learning each other. But I think there's a few things that I'm going to just share that I do with him that I think really help. One thing is patience. That's something I've really had to work on. I'm not a patient person by nature. And he is somebody who likes to take his time. He likes to think things through before he makes a jump decision. Or, if I'm asking him a question, he likes to take the time to think about it. So I have trained myself, and I'm not always good at it, but to just let him take the time to answer the question. If I ask him, what do you want for lunch? I might have to wait a minute before he says it. Or if I say, Jacob, I want you to go pick up your toys. It's not something that he's being naughty by not doing it right away. He needs the time to process. Okay, my toys, they're in the living room. They're going to go into the basket or those toys go in my room. Do you know what I mean? So I don't like to ask him 100 times. If he still doesn't do it within a minute or something, I'll ask again. Because sometimes kids are kids and they will be naughty and just not do it on purpose. But most of the time, it's just his personality and he just needs a second to sort of process it, right? Love you. Another thing that I will say with him, so patience is key. Patience is super, super key. Another thing is communication. So allowing yourself to communicate fully with your child. What I mean by that is if you're asking him a question, letting him fully answer that question. Or if he asks you a question, really trying to get down to his level, like to get to his eye level and explain to him my answer for the question. Sometimes the answer to his questions or, if he's asking for something or to go do something and the answer is no, we get a fit, right? You know that if you have kids, they don't want to hear the word no. They want to be able to do what they do. And so when I say no, I like to explain to him why I've said no. So, and it's not just, can I have a snack? No, supper's going to be right away. That's not really explaining it, right? I like to get down to his level and I like to say, no, buddy, because we've already had maybe 2 snacks and supper's going to be in like 10 minutes. And so we want to make sure that we have room in our tummies for our, for our food from supper. And so if there's still a fit there, I don't like to just get mad. What I like to do is then I like to address that fit as a completely different fit, right? Now I've said no, now I've explained why it's no. And if we still have him throwing a fit, I like to further explain, if that makes sense, and give him something fun to look forward to. So I'll say, again, I'll explain to him why the answer was no, and then I'll say, maybe, and I think of something that's really easy for me to do that doesn't really matter, like maybe we can have a snack after lunch, and I'll let you pick your snack. Is there something you wanted for snack? And then maybe he says, like, apples. Or maybe he says something like that. Or maybe I think about something that he likes and I just elaborate it. So like, if he says he wants apples, I go, do you want apples cut up into tiny little pieces? And Mommy can give you some peanut butter. Right? So I make it exciting for him. I don't make the answer just no and that's it and let's move forward, because he's a human himself and he doesn't want to hear no. And if I wanted a snack, or if I was hungry and it's like, I want a snack, and somebody said no to me, he'd be like, well, that's not fair. And I know he's a toddler and he has to follow my rules, but he's also a human who has feelings and emotions himself. And I try to remind myself of that. So patience, communication. And then another one that I try to do as often as I can that I think really helps Jacob. And again, these aren't going to be for everybody's kids, because kids are different. They're unique. Just we're people, right? They're unique. They're their own person. But another thing that I really think is really helpful for Jacob is really trying to say yes as much as I possibly can. If it doesn't, okay, careful. You can. I'm just saying be careful because I thought you were going to fall. So another one would be the fact that, so let me think. So we got patience, right? We've got communication. And another one is saying yes as much as I possibly can. I feel like in today's society, we are so busy that we just say no to our kids. You know, like if he wants me to get down on the ground and play with him, if he wants a snack, if he wants to go somewhere, if he wants whatever. I try to say yes as much as physically possible. If I can do it, I'll do it. Like, the only time I try to say no is if I cannot do it. So there's times where, like, say bedtime, where he wants an extra book. What's one extra book, right? So I'll say yes. And then, okay, kids are smart, right? They're going to figure out that, well, then I want another book. And that's when it's like, no, buddy, Mommy already read you. You're two, plus you got one, right? So there's something in there that, I don't know. It's just his personality with my personality and the way that we've worked with each other. If all of these make sense, I hope all of these make sense, but it's just the way that I've parented him. That's just the way I've parented him. I've just really tried to be very patient with him. Now, like I said, Jacob has toddler, you know, temper tantrums. He has fits. He has not very good days. I have not very good days with him. We just don't, you guys just don't see that, right? So, but I want you to know that he's human. I'm human. But you are a good kid. Aren't you?
Yeah.
Yeah, you're my good kid. And he's very sweet and he's very calm and he's compassionate. And like I said, it's just his personality. So anyway, guys, I appreciate all of the sweet comments about Jacob, because I do really think he's an awesome kid. And I appreciate all the things that people have said about me as a mom, because I think in today's society, there's a lot of mom shaming, and building moms up is just an awesome, awesome thing. And so if you are in a struggle with discipline with your kids right now, like I said, try to be patient. Try your hardest to be patient. That's probably my hardest thing. That's my biggest thing, is being patient. Really get down to their level and communicate. One little tip that I got given to me was to explain. So, like, we went through a phase of Jacob with hitting, and that was really bad, and it hurt, and it wasn't fun. Just like any other toddler, you know, goes through things. And I had really good advice. You good? I had really good advice from somebody that said, you know, basically that you have to let him understand what it is that he's doing. So, like, he hurt himself. He had pinched his finger in my mother and father-in-law's couch. It really hurt. He had a huge bruise on his finger. And so when he started to hurt people in any way, whether that was hitting or yelling or, you know, being aggressive or pushing, and I would just say to him, you know, do you remember when you were littler and you hurt your finger, you pinched it really bad in grandma and grandpa's house, and it was bruised and it was sore and you cried? And he'll say, yeah, because he remembers that, because it was traumatic for him. And then I explained to him, well, that's how Mommy feels when you push me. That doesn't feel nice to Mommy. That hurts. And so his little brain is realizing, like, I don't want anybody to feel that pain. So that's another tip that I got given to me. I know that this video is all over the place, but that's because I really don't have parenting tips. This is just what I do with him. But I hope that any of this helps you guys. If you are in, you know, some sort of disciplining, you know, struggle, just know that I've been there. Just know that every mom has been there. And if they're telling you that they haven't been, they're lying. Because it's tough. It's not easy being a parent. The balance between trying to, you know, let them live and, you know, enjoy life versus trying to discipline them and teach them is a really tough balance. And we've all been through it. So anyway, guys, I hope you enjoyed this video. I hope that it made sense. I hope that it helped you. Let me know in the comments down below, what do you guys do to discipline your toddlers, your children? What are some things that really work for them and are, you know, really awesome for teaching them and helping them grow? Anyway, guys, thank you so much for watching this video. Give it a big thumbs up for Jacob being in my video, even though he is wiggly. And we will see you in my next one. Bye, guys.
Bye, guys.